One of the greatest miracles on earth is taking place at this very moment. Various images are appearing on the screen, and perceptions such as color, life, closeness, distance, depth, beauty, and lovableness are forming somewhere in the pitch dark in your brain. That is because you are seeing. Whatever you have in your life is meaningful through your senses, vision, and others. Your family, your friends, your house, your office, and everything else in your surroundings, you quickly identify thanks to your vision. Without eyes, you could never get a quick, complete sense of everything that's happening around you. Without them, you could never imagine colors, forms, scenes, or human faces. But you do have eyes, and thanks to them, you can see your surroundings, and you are at this moment able to watch this film. Nor does the act of vision cost you very much effort. To see an object, all you have to do is turn your gaze at it. You don't need to bother giving project, capture, and analyze orders to your eyes, the optical nerves running to the back of your brain, nor to the brain itself. Without having to work out the optical measurement, your eye's lens can focus onto distant objects. You only desire to see, and within a fraction of a second, that process is carried out for you. But are you aware what a great miracle sight actually is? Do not forget, every moment we open or close our eyes, every image we see, are means for us to give thanks to Almighty God, who created everything out of nothing. God brought you out of your mother's wombs, knowing nothing at all, and gave you hearing, sight, and hearts, so that perhaps you would show thanks. Over the last few seconds, approximately 100 billion operations have been completed inside your eyes. However fantastic it may seem, you possess an example of the universe's ultimate technology. No scientist has ever come close to fully grasping it, let alone inventing anything remotely similar. Considering the eye's complex structure and special function, it occupies only a very small volume of our body. Its location enables us to control and direct our bodies and limbs in an optimum way. Imagine for a moment if our eyes were fixed somewhere on our knees, or worse, our ankles. Since we could see nothing more than the path we were walking, upper parts of our bodies, especially the head, would keep banging into unseen obstacles. Given such a mismatched anatomy, many routine tasks like eating or using tools would become problems in their own right. Beside the optimum location in the body, your eyes are also situated in a perfect position on the face. Were they anywhere else, under the nose, for example, it would be a literally uphill struggle to provide the same safe viewing angle, not to mention the aesthetic appearance. The eyes are ideally positioned at an area most comfortable for vision. The wondrous features of the eye go much further than that, however. From the eyelashes to the cornea, From tear formation to the eyelids, there is a separate miracle in every detail. Without being aware of it, people blink their eyes thousands of times a day. These mostly involuntary movements make it possible for the eyes to preserve themselves from intense light and external particles. By blinking every few seconds, as if on autopilot, the eyelids moisten and cleanse the eyes like a car's windshield wipers. While opening and shutting, the eyelid perfectly fits the convex shape of the eye, contacting the entire surface of the eye's outside layer. Did the eyelid not fit the eyeball's curve so precisely, it would be impossible to remove dust particles remaining in the unreachable corners of the eye's enclaves. This unconscious operation, which most people take for granted, is actually an important blessing. What if it were not automatic? Human beings would remember to blink only after detectably large amounts of substance had already accumulated in their eyes. Since the tiniest speck of dust entering the eye would eventually create major problems, this would lead to infection. Besides, due to this incomplete halfway cleaning, vision would be blurred. Another critical point in the blinking process is its duration. For survival, man needs to be informed, with no interruptions, of his ever-changing environment. To satisfy this condition, blinking occupies only a very brief time without disrupting the continuity of perception. Any longer blinking time might have caused serious dangers, while driving on the highway, for instance, and not noticing a suddenly appearing car in time to swerve. These delicate balances in the blinking processes, which we perform unconsciously right from the moment we are born, are one of the manifestations of God's incomparable creation. O man, what has deluded you in respect of your noble Lord? He who created you and formed you and proportioned you and